In this video, we will discuss kinetic energy of generalized velocities.
Hello friends, in this video we will discuss the kinetic energy as homogeneous quadratic functions of generalized velocity. We shall prove one example. The example is like this. Find the expression for kinetic energy as the quadratic function of generalized velocities. Here we have to obtain the expression for kinetic energy as the quadratic function of generalized velocities. Further show that when the constraints are scleronomic, and the kinetic energy T is a homogeneous quadratic function of generalized velocities, then sum over j qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to 2t. And second part we have to prove, when the constraints are aryonomic, then sum over j of qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to 2t2 plus t1, where t1 and t2 are homogeneous functions of generalized velocities of degree 1. And 2 respectively. In this example, we have to find the expression for kinetic energy as a quadratic function of generalized velocities, and further we have to show that when the constraints are scleronomic and the kinetic energy T is a homogeneous quadratic function of generalized velocities, then sum over j qj dot dou t by dou qj dot is nothing but 2t. Further, when the constraints are aryonomic, then sum over j qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to 2t2 plus t1, where T1 and T2 are homogeneous functions of generalized velocities of degree 1 and degree 2 respectively. That means T1 is a function of degree 1 and T2 is of degree 2. We shall prove this. For proving this, we shall consider a system of particles of masses MI and position vectors RI. Generally, for rheonomic system, we have Ri equal to Ri of Q1, Q2, Q3, Qn and T. Suppose this is equation 1. Then the time derivative of this equation, gives dou Ri by dou T is nothing but Ri dot equal to sigma over k, or in simple way sigma over k dou Ri by dou Qk into dou Qk by dou T plus dou Ri by dou T, which is nothing but sum over k dou Ri by dou Qk into Qk dot, dou Qk by dou T is nothing but derivative of Qk, plus dou Ri by dou T. This is equation 2. Now, the kinetic energy T is given by 1 by 2 sum over I MI into RI dot square. That becomes T equal to 1 by 2 sum over I MI, and we shall substitute value of RI dot from above equation, and that value is sum over j dou Ri by dou Qj into Qj dot plus dou Ri by dou T into sum over k of dou Ri by dou Qk into Qk dot plus dou Ri by dou T, which is nothing but this is equal to 1 by 2 sum over R of MI into, we shall multiply these two sums, that is nothing but sum over jk dou Ri by dou Qj into dou Ri by dou Qk into Qj dot Qk dot plus 2 times sum over j of dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou qk into qj dot dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou t, not dou qk, dou t into qj dot plus dou ri by dou t bracket square. This is the product of these two sums. That is nothing but t is equal to 1 by 2 sum over I of mi of all this sum. Sum over jk dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou qk into qj dot qk dot plus 2 times sum over j dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou t into qj dot plus dou ri by dou t bracket square. Now we know that the finite sum can be interchanged. Since the finite sum can be interchanged, we can write the above expression as t equal to sum over jk of 1 by 2 sum over I mi dou ri by dou qj dou ri by dou qk into qj dot qk dot plus sum over j of sum over I of mi into dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou t into qj dot plus sum over I of 1 by 2 mi dou ri by dou t bracket square. This is the value of t. That can be written as t equal to sigma over jk of qjk qj dot qk dot plus sigma over j aj qj dot plus a. This is equation 3, where qjk equal to qjk equal to what? 1 by 2 mi into dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou qk. Qjk equal to sum of 1 by 2 mi dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou qk. Aj equal to second coefficient. Aj equal to sum over mi, sum over I mi dou ri by dou qj into dou ri by dou t. This is sum over I. A equal to sum over I 1 by 2 mi dou ri by dou t bracket square. If we substitute this value in above equation, we will get the equation 3 as a t equal to sum over jk of qjk qj dot qk dot plus sum over j aj qj dot plus aj plus a. These three functions ajk, aj and aj, these are definite functions of R and T. Hence, the functions of Q, S and T are, hence, the functions of Q's and T are these are definite functions of R and T, and hence the function of Q's and T. Definite functions of AJK, AJ and A are also definite functions of Q's and T. Thus, for rheonomic system, the kinetic energy is obtained by equation 3 that is T equal to sigma over jk ajk qj dot qk dot plus sigma over j aj into qj dot plus a, which is the quadratic function of generalized velocity. Quadratic function of Q and T, that is generalized velocity. Now we shall prove first case. For that, if the constraint are scleronomic, case 1, if the constraints are scleronomic, then the transformation equation do not contain time t explicitly. And then we have dou ri by dou t equal to 0, and hence a and aj vanishes. In above equation, a contains dou ri by dou t, aj contains dou ri by dou t, and as dou ri by dou t is equal to 0, these two functions aj and a vanishes. Therefore, the equation 3 becomes t equal to sigma over jk of ajk qj dot qk dot, and other terms vanishes. What this shows? From this, rheonomic system of kinetic energy, thus for the scleronomic system, the kinetic energy is homogeneous function of generalized velocities. Homogeneous functions of generalized velocities. Now we apply Euler's theorem. The kinetic energy function. Suppose this is equation 4. We find in equation 4 we get, what will we get? Sigma over j of qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to t. This is equation. You can note that, we have to note that this equation 4 is not always true even if the constraints are scalenic. Even if the constraints are scalenomic. The transformation equation involves time t. Transformation equation involves time t. Involve time t or do not involve time t. Explicitly, because of the rotating coordinate system or due to some other reason. Due to some other reason. Consequently, the kinetic energy T will not be the homogeneous quadratic function generalized velocity. Consequently, the kinetic energy T will not be a homogeneous function, homogeneous quadratic function generalized velocity as it contains additional rotational terms involving or not involving, rotational terms involving or not involving generalized velocities. And hence, the equation phi u, that is sigma over j qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to 2t becomes, hence, equation phi u becomes equation phi u can be sigma over j qj dot dou t by dou qj equal to 2t plus terms containing t1 and or t0, where t1 is homogeneous function of generalized velocities of degree 1 and T naught is term not involving generalized velocities. This is equation phi u a. If a dynamical system only in translational motion that means inertial coordinate system that is rotation of the kind is absent, is a scleronomic, then T is always homogeneous quadratic function of generalized velocities. And thus equation phi u holds. Now we shall consider case 2. If the constraints are rheonomic, then none of the functions AJK, AJ and A is 0. Therefore, T can be written as T2 plus T1 plus T0. And therefore, where where t2 equal to sigma over jk a jk qj dot qk dot, t1 equal to sigma over j aj qj dot, and t0 equal to 1 by 2 sigma over I 1 by 2 mi dou ri by dou t bracket square. These are t2, t1 and t0. These are homogeneous functions of generalized velocities of degree 2. Generalized velocities of degree 2. 1 and 0 respectively. Differentiating equation 7 with respect to qj dot and multiplying it by qj dot and then summing over j we can obtain. That means we have to differentiate this equation with respect to qj dot, then multiply it by qj dot and sum it. We will get sum over j of qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to sum over j qj dot dou tt by dou qj dot plus sum over j qj dot dou t1 by dou qj dot plus sum over j qj dot dou t0 by dou qj dot. Now we apply Euler's theorem for the homogeneous function to each term on right hand side of above equation, we get sigma over j qj dot dou t by dou qj, this is right hand side, and we are applying Euler's theorem on these two right hand side terms. We will get this is equal to 2t2 plus t1 and last term becomes 0. This is equation number 9 and this completes the proof. We shall write some remarks on this problem, theoretical problem of course. Sometimes it may happen that though the constraints are rheonomic, yet the kinetic energy expression of the system leads to the result. Sigma over j qj dot dou t by dou qj dot equal to 2t minus 2t naught due to the rotating coordinate system. Thank you.